What's up, everybody? New Nostalgia bringing you some more Grimdawn Crucible. We're just gonna begin right off the bat. We're in a lovely forest arena this time, a little bit of a difference.
Have you not been here before?
No, have you?
I've been here once.
Okay, no, I've only been in the Harpy stage and the first stage.
Oh yeah, I forgot about the Harpy stage. I think there's one more, I think.
Maybe. I would believe it. But yeah, I guess it just matters on, like, where it puts you when you load into the game at the start.
Yeah.
Which is fine.
It'll be their own little different setups, it seems.
Yeah, I'm down with this one. It seems like there's some safe havens up top, maybe.
Yeah, for the most part.
Yeah.
I momentarily forgot how to play my guy, so give me one second.
That's fine. Turn on any things that you need to turn on.
I have, like, none. Cadence? No. Alright, I guess I'm good.
Yeah? And you're doing, so like,
like, builds for Crucible and stuff.
Right. How'd that go?
Like, doesn't seem to be anyone, like, really doing it just for Crucible, because most classes are pretty viable, I guess.
Yeah, that would make sense. You know, if it can work here, it can work in the story, I'm sure.
Yeah.
And vice versa.
But someone raised the question of, like, what happens if I use all of my devotion points from the Crucible, and then I activate a shrine in the main game?
I bet you just probably get loot and no points,
you
right?
Just get loot.
Yeah, there you go. Because aren't there more statues than there are points in the campaign? There's like 59, but you can only get 50 points.
Is there? Because I have no idea.
I think so. I think that was... Like, I read through the list, and I think there's a few more than 50, at least.
I'm just piecing this together as I go. How many tribute points do you have?
Zero. Yeah, do you have some?
I've got three.
Oh, I must have spent them, I guess.
Well, we did the thing where I got the thing first, and then we upgraded it, which cost like 8 points.
Right.
So we got a little out, but at wave 20, we can put down a statue.
Yeah. Down with that.
Or save the points, it doesn't matter.
You know what, we can try to push it. We'll see how we're doing by wave 20.
Yeah.
If we're holding it down. I see no reason why not. We're doing pretty good so far. Wave 9, no issues at all.
I think I'm gonna have to get a glass of water at wave 20.
Yeah, no problem. You can do it after 10 if you like.
Oh yeah, I might just... So what have you been up to today?
I went down to work and ran one of my staff through the... Whoa!
Did you go down?
I actually don't know what killed me. You're fine, but I ran one of my staff through the new room so that they can actually host it when I'm not around.
Nice.
But that's...
I guess someone has to know how to do it.
Yeah, pretty everybody but one person knows how to do it now, and if that lady gets a booking for that room before she goes through it, I'll just go down and do it.
That's fair enough.
Yeah, it's not a big deal. Sorry?
How late do they open?
We open at noon, and we close during a week. We won't normally take a booking later than 7:30, so we close around 8:39. On the weekend, we'll stay open and take bookings until like 9 p.m. normally.
That's pretty sweet. Do you do walk-ins, or do you have to make a reservation?
The official rule is make a reservation within 12 hours, or before the 12-hour like grace period. But, you know, if you walk in and we've got a room open, we'll check you in there.
That's sweet.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be right back.
Yeah, take your time.
Good.
Alright, let's resummon my doggo. And there we go. Look at this cute, like, weird bramble puppy. What a lovely fellow. I feel like we should name him. Summon Briarthorn. Yeah, that's not a name. That's just a type of beast. I don't know, we'll see what John thinks. He needs a cute name, like Frank. Or Brian. Brian the Briarthorn? Yeah, there you go. I think John is back.
And I'm back.
We did it, Reddit. I was just prattling on a bit. We need to name my doggo here, my Briarthorn.
Your Briarthorn?
Yeah, I'm thinking Brian.
Brian the Briarthorn.
Yeah. Unless you got a better idea.
That's pretty solid. I could see him working in an office somewhere.
Yeah, you know, he's wearing like a suit and tie, but just like a casual suit and tie, not a tux. Making phone calls, paging his secretary, being like, Sharon, cancel my 1 o'clock. I've got a Windraptor Skylord to slay.
Windraptor Skylord.
Yeah, that was the name of that guy that we just killed.
Was
the,
it?
Yeah, the big bat that seems to always spawn on wave 11. That's a Windraptor. I didn't just pull that one off the top of the noggin.
I thought you did, and it sounded real believable. You could have just kept going. I would have believed you.
You know what? I'm not that kind of guy most of the time.
Most of the time.
Every now and then, maybe, but I prefer to keep my memes wholesome and true.
Wholesome and true.
Wholesome and true.
That's rich.
I know. I'm like
I'm part of the Facebook group chat. I see what memes get pumped into.
They're mostly Hannah's memes. She's better
they
at
are
memes.
Mostly Hannah's memes.
She's my memestress. Okay, did you... Alright, you know, like, a female person who sews is called a seamstress, right?
Yeah, seamstress.
Do you know what the male equivalent is?
No.
It is a seaman.
No, it's not.
It is.
No, it's...
It is. I tutor a guy, and he was talking about how his uncle is, like, really into...
Seaman.
No, he's really into, Ella Montgomery? Is that right? The lady who wrote, Anne of Green Gables.
Oh,
Lucy Maud Montgomery, yeah, that's correct. So anyway, he's like a bit of a historian on her works and her poetry and all that. So he looked up or acquired copies of her original notes and found like the original dress that Anne's dress was based off of and yada yada. And he made it. He made the original that it was based on and it toured around Canada. And all this to say that the man who I tutor, his uncle, is by trade a seaman. But there is no ocean faring involved.
Aww.
Yeah, that's interesting, though. I mean, why not just, like, a seamster or something?
Seamster.
Yeah, a seamstress and a seamster.
You.
Exactly. See, that makes a lot of sense, I think. Maybe I'm crazy, though. I don't know.
Are you sure it's seaman? Because that just sounds like... I think I would have heard about that by now.
You know what? If it's not, his uncle has been trolling him for, like, 28 years.
I believe you, though.
I mean, I guess it's literally anecdotal. I only have one source.
Not to believe you. You never lie to me, right?
You know what? This is so ridiculous that it, I don't think I could make up a lie that was that, you know, coherent and ridiculous. My lies are too transparent.
That's true. Leave the lying up to me. Don't worry about it.
Exactly. You get it. Oh my god, these Chillmane Rangers.
Why are they only after you, though?
I don't know, but I kited effectively for once in my life, I think.
Yeah, you did work.
I did. I do a lot of damage, still.
Oh man, dill pickles are good. Do you like dill pickles?
I am pro dill pickle. What's your favorite brand of pickle?
And kosher dill pickles are, right?
Yeah, I'm for
it's,
that.
It's like pretty much the staple, you know, you get it in the jar.
I'm for that.
But I will gladly take anything weird, like Amish branded stuff.
Amish branded dill pickles.
Have you ever had like a spicy pickle? It's like jarred pickles.
Don't know if I ever
had. Spices.
That sounds good. I think I'm for that.
Like a buttered pickle, I think that's what it's called.
I have had buttered pickles, but that's not a spiced pickle. That's a different
thing. It's kind of like spice. Like, they're all jarred.
Yeah, but like a bread and butter pickle, that's a different pickle, isn't it? That's like a sandwich pickle.
Yeah, it's kind of like a sandwich pickle.
Yeah.
The point is you can put this on a cracker with some cheese and eat it.
Okay, interesting.
And it's delicious.
I believe it. I don't know if I'd, you know, immediately go to like, oh, I really like this pickle. I'm going to put it on a cracker, but like, I can respect that.
You don't have to put it on the cracker. You eat it with your crackers and cheese.
Yeah, all right, that's fair.
If you do the crackers and cheese thing.
Well, I'm lactose intolerant, so I don't cheese it up too often.
Right.
Sometimes I will endeavor to have a little cheesy goodness, but mostly I do not.
That is the worst. Can you just get some surgery for that or something?
Get some surgery for my lactose intolerance.
Put your head on someone else's body so you can eat crackers and cheese.
Oh my gosh. I nearly died when I was a young boy eating a cracker sandwich.
Oh god, I don't mean to make light of your near-death experience with cheese.
It was not related to the lactose intolerance. It was actually... So, when I was little, I enjoyed making just, like, weird food concoctions. So my mom would make me up, like, a nice, relatively healthy snack of, like, small pieces of cheese, crackers, and grapes on a plate. So, you know, that makes sense. So me, in all my wisdom, I would put a cracker down, put a piece of cheese on it, put a grape on that, put a piece of cheese on that, and then put a cracker on the top. I'd make a little grape sandwich. And I actually choked on one, and only my father was home, and he's not the best adult in the world. Only for me just being able to, like, make myself cough it up, I think I actually would have been killed by a grape sandwich.
Holy crap, how'd you manage?
I just kind of, like, hit my back off of, like, a door, like a corner kind of thing. You probably would have just died.
I'm prone to giving into fate easily. Like,
I believe that.
When I notice I'm gonna start dying, it's like, alright.
Yeah, here we go. It was nice while it lasted, this whole living thing.
I'm just saying I'm not gonna pass up the opportunity.
Yeah, that's fair.
Getting pretty rough.
Yeah, these guys are real strong. We're getting up there already at wave 23.
Did your briar dog die?
Oh, you know what? He probably did. I don't really have, like, a pet bar for him, or at least not one that I pay attention to. If it does exist. It
pops up in the top left screen there.
Oh, so it does. Alright. I thought that was my portrait this whole time, like Diablo style. Does it do that in multiplayer in Diablo? I don't know anything. You know what? It does it in WoW. That's the WoW portrait.
That's true.
Yeah. So, yeah, alright. I'm definitely wrong, but there's a reason for it.
We're on wave 24. We're doing work.
We're doing pretty well.
I have no AoE, and I didn't put down a turret, so...
That's okay. Probably no turrets. We'll stick it out to 30. See what we can do after that. If we can even, you know, make it that far.
I think we can. I mean, 25, like, the hard part is when we get two bosses.
The hard part is wave 30 itself.
That's true.
That boss is ridiculous. This guy is also a little bit of a problem sometimes. He goes down real fast, but, like, he can hit hard.
I can push him away, which is quite nice.
That's pretty good. I like the design of these insectoid guys. I don't like the lich from Guild Wars 1 over here, though. Not a big fan of that. He's real strong.
That's a game I haven't played in a while.
I loved Guild Wars 1 a whole bunch. I don't know if we've ever fought this guy. He is healing a lot. Are you standing in, like, a pit or something?
It looks like poison.
Yeah. I don't know, maybe that heals?
I probably shouldn't stay in that.
He healed again! Alright, you know what? There are minions left alive that must be healing him. I don't know. There's more back here.
Are they even doing... Did we freeze?
No, there's Rift Hounds. Oh, he's summoning them, though. I'm not sure.
Okay.
Maybe we have to kill them within a certain time, or they do heal him, so I'll work on killing adds, I guess.
Alright, I'm just gonna focus on this guy.
Yeah.
He's being a real butt.
He is, yeah. Bit of a jerk. Alright, this is about where he heals normally. I think killing the adds had some effect.
Oh, there we go.
Alright.
Pretty low on health, but alright.
Yeah, how you doing for potions?
I've got 86.
You're doing just fine. I've got 31, but I haven't used too many.
Okay, well, like, in a quick emergency, I can split the stack and throw it down.
That's true. I think we're fine.
Yeah, we're good.
It should be relatively smooth sailing until wave 30 itself.
Until we hit Van Helsing.
Yeah. Speaking of Van Helsing, there's a Netflix series called Van Helsing. Have you heard of this or checked it out even?
I have seen it. I haven't like watched the show. I've seen like the trailer, kind of.
Okay, what? How's it looking? I haven't even heard of it.
Honestly, it looks like a straight-to-DVD movie, but
it is on Netflix. I haven't
seen enough of it to judge.
Yeah, fair enough. I've been watching some Z Nation in my downtime, mostly when I fold laundry and such. It's
Z Nation?
It's terrible, and I love it. It's basically...
I don't think I've ever seen that.
It's like a shitty... Well, you know the movie company Asylum? They make, like, the bad horror movies?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is their take on The Walking Dead, basically.
Oh, okay.
But you know what? It's a lot of fun. In the first episode, they kill a zombie baby.
They kill a zombie baby?
Yeah, it's like an actual baby, and it's a zombie, and it's real fast, and it murders at least one person.
That's terrifying.
It's a good time.
Like, B-movies or shows are good. They're good when they don't take themselves seriously.
Exactly. This show so far, I'm only like 3 or 4 episodes in, has the correct amount of serious to not serious.
Yeah.
But it's a breath of fresh freaking air from The Walking Dead, which has just gotten stale for me.
Yeah, have you watched up to the latest season there?
Yeah, I stopped watching this season. I should have stopped watching like 4 seasons ago.
I'm starting to feel that way about Supernatural.
You're still watching Supernatural.
We're on, like, the semi-last season, I think.
Yeah, that doesn't exist. They're not gonna end that show.
No, I mean, it's, like, the latest-ish season.
Yeah.
Kind of.
No, they'll keep going until, literally, there's no money to be made, and then they'll make a movie.
I'll still watch it.
You know what? I would watch a Supernatural movie. Probably.
I would have watched the Supernatural movie if it ended at, like, season 5.
Yeah, that's fair. Season 5 probably could have been a movie, and it would have been fine. Season 30,
by the way.
Yeah, we're doing fine so far.
Yeah. Zaria the Carver is,
Alright, speaking of Carver, who is your favorite Weekender?
Favorite Weekender?
Yeah, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
Oh, man. I want to say his name was Gus. It's not Gus.
No, that's Recess.
That's Recess.
Yeah. Gus Griswold.
Yeah.
Tino? Is that who you're trying to think about?
I think so.
The little blonde kid, more or less the main character.
Yes.
Yeah. Tino Tonatini.
Man.
Yeah.
You're the full name.
Then, you got Lore and you got, oh, man. What was the other ones? Tish. Yeah.
Tish,
Lore, Tino, and Carver.
I know what you did with your Saturday mornings.
Yeah. Those shows were always on. There was no avoiding them. And they were fine. Like, I genuinely enjoyed them. I think Recess is a damn good show. I thought the Weekenders were tons of fun. So, Tino... I haven't
watched any of these in a long time.
I mean, me either, but I remember them. They were important parts of my formative years.
I used to watch a lot of the Power Rangers when I was younger.
Yeah, I didn't... I watched, like, probably the regular amount of Power Rangers, but I didn't watch a lot of it.
I was fairly obsessed when I was younger.
Alright, so we beat Wave 30 with, like, no issue. Do we build turrets and try to carry on, or do we get the rewards?
You've got 3 tribute points, right?
I have 4 now.
Got 4, huh? We only have enough for 1 regular turret.
Right.
If we put one down.
Yeah. Oh, I leveled up, by the way.
Sweet. So did I. Okay.
Hell yeah.
Housekeeping.
Yeah, housekeeping. Alright. You think we can do it? How many points do you have?
I've got 7 points.
That's 7 points.
Yeah.
It's your call, because they'd be your points.
You know, it would probably help with ads. If we had one down.
I think so. If we're gonna continue on.
Yeah, so like right here?
Yeah, I think so. Do we want to do the electric one?
Yeah, I'm thinking the electric one, unless you can think of a better spot for it.
No, that seems good. And then if we get enough to build another one, we could build, like, the fire one right where I'm at.
Alright.
We can give her a shot.
Stormcaller.
Alright.
Alright.
Let's begin, or do you need to buy potions?
Let me just put some points in real quick.
Yeah, absolutely.
Not that I have any points anyways.
Take your time. I'm gonna stock back up on potions, just in case. I imagine 30 will be enough for 10 waves. But just in case it's not. Alright, ready when you are.
I am ready.
Alright, you sounded very confident.
I'm as ready as I'm gonna be.
Alright, we got a boss over in the top right quadrant. He hurts a lot. Okay. Do your best to survive. I'm gonna do my best to kite around.
Sounds solid. I'm just gonna try and whittle down the boss.
Yeah. He seems to be pretty interested in me right now.
Yeah. He's going down, though.
He's going down. All in all, this was pretty easy as far as waves go.
Yeah. I just hate to see wave 30. Okay, I've got a glowing skull underneath my timer.
Underneath your timer? Oh. Players have reduced health, but are more resistant to vitality drains. So we're debuffed now because we made it far enough?
Yeah, this is one of the things that the Crucible guy does it.
Interesting. I thought that only happened if we were taking too long, or maybe we did take too long.
Maybe we did.
I believe it.
Yeah, I know there's like one where like spell casting gets reduced, but you do more damage or something like that.
Okay. At least they're not just straight debuffs, it's kind of a change.
Yeah.
Which is fine. We will grow and adapt, maybe.
Players have reduced health, but are more resistant to vitality drains. Okay.
Yeah, so I can see that being a useful thing. Oh my god.
Dang.
He's the biggest man in the world. Alright, I've got one boss on me. I think you've got the big guy on you.
Yeah.
Alright, I have killed this boss.
This one's going down.
Alright, I'm on my way over.
The lightning statue is a worthy investment.
Yeah, it seems to always pull its weight. Oh, jeez.
Okay. This is a mess.
Yep. I need to make my entangling roots slow, like, way better. Maybe that's what I'll spend my next level up on. Because, like, it's holding it down. You have 6 points to spend. What are you doing?
I had 6 points.
Oh, you had 6.
I guess I didn't do my last level.
Right, fair enough. Alright, there's... Oh my god. Whew, I froze for a hot second. I think I actually, like, clicked on my other monitor, and that's just the Grimbound way.
Yep.
The whole thing freezes, which is interesting.
Okay, this thing is...
Alright, at the very least... Oh my god, this is freaking Warden Krieg!
Okay, I knew we'd see him.
Yeah. Alright, well, he's going down, though. Everybody's been going down pretty easy, except for the Wave 30 guy.
Is he gonna transform?
Oh my god.
If he does, he does.
Okay.
So, just run.
Yeah.
And
oh my god.
And do control first.
Yeah. Doing my best.
Holy moly. These things are everywhere.
Yeah, there's no escape. Thank God for entangling roots.
Yeah,
it's,
really.
It's holding it down. It needs to be upgraded more, but it's holding it down. Oh my god. These little, like, manticore things are crazy. Oh my god. We're doing it. I hate that more waves are coming as Krieg is still alive.
Yeah, I'm trying to do something about Krieg.
Yeah. Oh shit, there's another huge man.
Yeah, just keep running.
Oh my god. Yeah, just keep running.
Warden Krieg's almost gone.
That's good. It's the best news I've heard all day. I'm just trying to not get like one shot. Mostly
me too.
Most success so far.
Come on, Worm. Just go down with me. Alright, he's down.
Alright, he's down, that's good.
What is this?
Yeah, I don't know, like I think the green man created the red man, but now we've got both men to deal with. Or maybe yeah, I'm not sure what that means, but it can't be good, is my thinking.
Okay.
So, I think poison counts as a vitality draining effect, because I am not taking too much damage from the poison.
Oh, gotta go fast.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Me as well.
Come on, me.
Alright, we're doing it, we're doing it.
Red guy's down.
Red guy's down. If he creates another red man, I'll be displeased.
Yeah. I don't think he's going to, I think he's going down.
I think so too. Alright, that was an intense few waves.
Yeah, if it wasn't for Warden creating
him. Yeah, the fact that he transforms and then sticks around. Like that, A, cool mechanic, I respect it. B, I don't ever want to deal with it again.
I'm pretty sure he's going to be a staple of the Crucible. I don't think the bosses change.
Yeah, it seems like there are fixed bosses for, fixed waves.
Yeah, at least this difficulty.
Yeah, that's true. It might be different on anything above Aspirant. Alright, we're on 39. We're doing it, boys. I'll try to deal with all the adds and the other boss over here. He's deflecting.
How are you doing kiting wise? Like,
I'm pretty good, actually.
Alright, this guy's been like summoning stuff constantly. He's gone now.
Alright. Alright. Wave 40.
Boss.
Yeah, several. Alright, okay. We've got a teleporting boss over here, and I don't like that at all.
That's an enemy hero.
Yeah. Alright. Makes kiting real difficult, real tricky.
Okay, yep.
Alright. Blood Feast the Ruthless. Come on, man. I think we can do this. Alright.
We got this.
Blood Feast is down. Damnoth is about to be.
Damnoth.
nice looties. Alright, we did it relatively painlessly. I think we gotta cash out here, though.
Yeah, I don't think we can make it to wave 50.
Alright, I wish to collect my reward. Alright, we got a level and, like, almost another one. Jump down with. Let's check out our dank loot.
I almost accidentally restarted the Crucible.
Oh, I would have had to actually kill you. IRL. All right.
Chests galore.
Yeah. Oh, I got one epic. How are you doing for epics?
Yeah, it looks like there's two epics.
Nice. Gut Wrench Eviscerator. Sounds pretty cool. That's an epic.
Sounds like my ex-girlfriend.
Oh. Zing. All right. There's like so many things on the screen that I can't correct fashion. Alright. Sort.
No room.
Alright. We did it right up.
Where's the guy got a sell crap?
To the left. To the left. Everything you can sell in a box to the left.
You might like these boots.
Yeah? Lay them on me.
Oh yeah, like 50% of like entrapment reduction. That sounds pretty sweet.
That does sound sweet. All right, I think we should do the obnoxious inventory management between episodes. Yeah. Thank you for watching. I can't believe we actually made it to wave 40 without catastrophe. We'll be back with some more. See ya.